Good morning, guys. The time is now 10 a.m. and it is Monday, May what?
23rd.
And it is the last day of my long weekend, Victoria Day. And so we have an exciting problem developing for the drama effects, but it's a real problem. Our ice machine seems to have stopped working. And so the only thing that we've been using our ice for mostly lately, water. It's for the water pitcher and for Ebo's water. And that's about it, the only stuff we use the ice for. And sometimes Matthew's parents would come along and would ask for ice, and because they do not have an ice machine on their fridge, and that will make the ice run out. But that has not happened this week, so don't know why the ice machine is not working. And so right now the weather for today, it continues to be yucky and wet and gloomy. Really, really yucky weather. Continues to be like that. Basically the same stuff you saw yesterday. And yeah, because usually for us it happens on the May long weekend anyway, so it's like no shocker. And yeah, and so right now for breakfast, probably waiting for Matthew to, when his conference call is done from his work, maybe gonna make him make some bacon and eggs and stuff for breakfast. And in the meantime, I'm gonna have a chocolate chip muffin that we bought yesterday. And a cup of tea. And yeah. And also later, when breakfast is done, we are probably going to be doing the macarons kit finally. And I think the only thing about the macarons kit is that they do not include the flavoring for the shells. You have to add your own flavoring. So the green color does not correlate to the flavor's choice. So usually green color is pistachio flavor. So maybe we're gonna do just vanilla or the almond flavor. So it's like whatever. And yeah, so that's a little bit. Are you trying to get your few seconds of fame on here? Because, really? And, yeah, not much else too crazy for now. That's the lowdown for today. And nowhere else to go really today. Alright, guys. Hey, guys. So, on one of those Facebook recipe threads, those little short video clips that you guys see on Facebook, like, I've seen one of these recipes, like, I don't want to imagine how many calories there is in one of those. Like, they basically have, like, make a grilled cheese sandwich, and then you wrap it around, like, in layers of bacon or something, and then you just make that as a grilled cheese sandwich. And then, I was just thinking to myself, and then it's like, we have bacon, and then Matthew is making something sandwich there. And I was like, that's getting me an idea now. Oh, and these muffins are actually pretty nice and pretty moist, and they are actually very loaded in chocolate chips. And these are actually 50% off, and I think the way this costed here, I don't think you can barely buy the one muffin at Starbucks, can you? And so yeah, those muffins are actually very, very good. And oh, and they actually expired yesterday and they're still good. And it's like, the modern problems is, I know that some people is too, like, you know what, and they wouldn't buy it, but it's like, whatever. So yeah. Not much else too crazy for now. Hey guys, so here's the grilled cheese sandwich done. And no, it is not wrapped in bacon. And there's the tea. But maybe one of these days we're gonna make a grilled cheese wrapped in bacon. So Maybe every so often you guys can remind me about that. I don't know. And so, yeah. So just having the Monday breakfast. And next up would be the macarons kit. All right. Hey, guys. So the time is now almost 3 o'clock, 2:45. And continuing the boring Monday. And so right now, the only thing we are doing is our macarons kit. And right now we have done the shells, and it made two pans of it, and it's gonna now rest for 10 minutes, and then we are gonna be putting it into the oven. So far it's working good. Hey guys, so this is the cookies, the cool down, and we started filling the cookies already, and we are like eating the cookies as we are filling them. Hey guys, so now the afternoon fun with the baking is done, and now I am getting ready to make dinner, and I am doing a chicken roast for dinner, a roast chicken, and haven't done one of these for a while. So in it goes to the preheated oven. There it is. And I almost forgot I had some of this Lipton stuff lingering around. And so I used a half of it on the chicken, and then I sprinkling half of the other pack, like the one envelope of it. And I use it for the gravy, for the stuff on the bottom, for the drippings. And yeah, so just having a roast chicken for dinner tonight, and it is perfect for today's gloomy weather. Hey guys, so the time is now just past 6 o'clock, and the chicken is actually ready early, really, really fast, and it cooked up very nice, and so now we are just waiting for the potatoes to cook up, and I was actually craving for mashed potatoes today. And you know the way sometimes it takes a large amount of potatoes to make a nice batch of mashed potatoes, because sometimes in the bag of potatoes you sometimes get all the small potatoes. And but Matthew thought I was crazy and said that I added way too much potatoes. But some days I just crave for mashed potatoes, and I might have one or two more servings for potatoes. And yeah, so this roast chicken dinner should stretch us out for the two more days, because I get paid on Thursday night. And so because Matthew got some funny shifts this week, and I actually got more normal shifts than Matthew do this week, and so still need to work out the time for our Mother's Day dinner with my mom. But that can happen anytime. It's no rush for that, right, guys? So, yeah, still need to work out the Mother's Day dinner with my mom. Still haven't done that yet. And, yeah, so just waiting for the mashed potatoes to get done. Hey, guys, so for our ice machine that I showed you this morning, it is working turtle speed. So I hope it is not something extra ka-ching we have to spend money on to fix. And I am trying this peach ginger sparkling soda thing, so I will tell you how it is. There's a gorgeous roast chicken. It cooked perfectly. And that Lipton herb thing, it smells amazing. And yeah, so you guys let me know if for your household, if that would be too much mashed potatoes, because I just have a craving for mashed potato, and yeah, so some days I am just like that, yeah. And right now, just digging into dinner. So just to show you guys that I'm not BSing you guys about the ice machine, there might be some experts out there, so gonna show you the sound that is coming from this ice. Can you guys hear that sound? And like I say, it is coming out like turtle speed. Can you guys hear that noise? I don't even know where it's coming from.
That's the thing, just trying to get ice.
Only two things of ice came. There's the rest of your ice for your drink. And yeah, so just to show you that I'm not being crazy with you guys. Hey guys, I'm back now, and so I just finished this drink. This peach ginger thingamabob, and I'm a little bit annoyed with it because I was expecting more of the ginger, like a ginger ale type of thing. But right away when you open the can, you can smell the peach and stuff. It was like more of like a peachy weird thing, and it's like, couldn't really taste the ginger part, so I don't even know why they put the ginger part in there. So yeah, so hope you guys had a lovely Monday. The chicken dinner was very good, and I'll be seeing you guys tomorrow.